Hello, people who cannot sit at home. Thank you so much for joining me. So before I go into this really fun video, I want to talk to you about my Ontario road trip journal. So this is from Toronto. So it's more about southern region of Ontario, and it actually has what I think are the best road trips in the area. So there are 12 larger road trips. Each of them have about 6 stops. There is also 28 shorter one stop, kind of one location road trips, but all of them do have things suggested. So you can go to a bunch of things on the way. And there's also 12 games that are just for fun. This is mainly for the spring, summer, and the fall time. So now let's talk about this video. This is actually a follow-up from the previous underrated road trips. I'm gonna link it somewhere over here. It's gonna be on the top. And that video did really well. It actually did really well on my TikTok. I also have a TikTok channel. It did well on YouTube. So this is a follow-up because clearly there is interest. And also there's gonna be, so this is part two, but there's also gonna be part three. And essentially these stops are underrated, meaning that I don't hear about a lot of people talking about them, but I think they're so magnificent, so pretty, so beautiful, and I think you should go. So without further ado, let's go. So for the first location, let's go to Quayle's Brewery. It is located slightly under Port Severn, and it's about an hour and a half, 2 hour drive, depending on the traffic, but this place is gorgeous. So the concept is nothing like I've ever tried before, and but once you understand the concept, it's so much fun. So this gorgeous place, that's where they actually make the beers, as I understand, and that's where you actually get the beer. But over here there's these crates, there's beer to go, where if you want to just take it, and there's also the other crate was the food ordering crate. And over here first you actually sit down, you get your table, and then you go into the main kind of area, the one that has the beer. And we got samplers of the beer. They were about $11. It was great, 4 samplers. And then I went in one of the crates and I ordered the food. So while waiting for the food, because they bring you the food, we wandered into the garden. And over here, this is their garden. It's beautiful, lots of flowers. But around the garden, there's also benches. You can sit at these benches as well, just while waiting for your food and, of course, eating the food. And there are these games that you can play. And also, you can walk around. I believe these are hops that the beer is made of. So these are gorgeous. And I'm sure this is going to get really filled in as the summer progresses. So I'm hoping to go here somewhere in August to check out the tunnels of hops. So the food is here, and the food was excellent. The burger and the tart I highly recommend, and out of their beers I really like their passion fruit beer and their raspberry beer. Okay, so the second gorgeous road trip is going to be in Penetanguishene. This is the port area of Penetang. Short name for Penetanguishene is Penetang. And over here is the world's famous dock lunch. You order, you put the toppings yourself, which is actually kind of great because, you know, you get to make your own sandwich. Excellent quality burgers, and right there is a port that you can walk, there's a dock you can walk on. And right next to this, about maybe 15 minute drive, is Awenda Provincial Park. Now what I really don't understand is why this park is not really well known, because it's an amazing park. So it does have tons of rocks, and you do need the shoes for the rocks because otherwise it's hard to walk, but it's beautiful. Just the scenery and the rocks and the sand is excellent. Definitely highly recommend this park. And up next is the Clarence's Classic. Now this is a double decker bus. Don't know, I just literally saw it a couple of days ago when we were over there. Don't know if this is every year or if this is the first year, but it was so cool. It's a full-on double decker and it has a Canadian flag, and yeah, it's just great. Lots of food. They have the fish and chips, they have burgers, hot dogs, and here are the hours. Monday is closed, but overall it's actually pretty much the whole day. Right next to, there's a really cool kids playground. And this pirate jug just flips over, and it's so fun to watch. The third fun experience is Oxford County Cheese Trail. Now, I actually done a whole video about this. I'm gonna link it down below that you can check out. But the short version of it is that first you go to the Ingersoll Cheese Museum. It's free entry. It's very interesting. Then we went to the Red Dragon Dairy. In there, they're known for their cheese curds. You can sample the cheese curds, and I actually loved all of them. I didn't try the plain one, but I loved all of them. And make sure to bring a cooler because you will want to buy the cheeses. I did not expect to be buying so much cheese. Here's the second stop on our Oxford cheese. It's a Gons Hill cheeses, and again, amazing cheeses. You can even see how the cheeses are made. They also do the tours, but they're about once a month. Five Brothers was by far my favorite cheese. And the last cheese place that we went to was the Mountain Oak cheese. And again, they're absolutely excellent. I got this Gouda, it was amazing. That's their best seller. If you ask them for the best seller, they will show you that. But the Oxford County Cheese Trail actually has tons of participants and lots more. This is just some of them. Okay, up next we have Haliburton Sculpture Forest. This is in Haliburton, which is about 2 hours 45 minutes. But I think there's a lot to do in Haliburton. I am also in future gonna do a video about all of the things you can do in Haliburton. And this is one of my favorites. I've been here in the summer, I've been here in the winter. Both times are amazing. My first stop is actually I go over here to this deck and I just sit and look at this view. And it doesn't get old, no matter what year, no matter what time of the year it is. The entry to the Sculpture Forest is free. You are encouraged to, of course, donate, put a donation if you would like to. Right now, there is an interesting exhibit of knitted things on the trees. But overall, the Sculpture Forest actually is mainly known for the physical, like a metal sculpture, stone sculptures. I would say there's maybe about from 20 to 30 of them. You just walk around and kind of discover them. It's much easier to discover them once the leaves are down. But you still will see everything, it's just you need to look more. This is one of my favorites. It's I See a Wish, and it's a gorgeous dandelion. And when you have it all surrounded by greenery, it looks so beautiful. So the Haliburton Forest is actually right next to the Fleming College, Haliburton campus. And over here I went in for the bathroom and I checked out this gorgeous sand sculpture. So outside of, again, Fleming College, you see other elements of the Sculpture Forest, and there's a couple of more over here. Now about the Haliburton, Castle Antiques Cafe is amazing. If you're there in Haliburton, you need to check this cafe out. It is surprisingly and very deceivingly very large inside. I spent about an hour just looking through all of the vintage things. They are the most elaborate, unusual vintage things I've ever seen. And of course, they also have a cafe. So I tried the sweets. I tried that berry tart, and I tried their cake, their chocolate cake, and they were excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. And over here, you can sit down. Lots of place to kind of relax. And I love this hippo table. Wish I had space for that. That's so cool. So anyway, make sure to check it out. Amazing place. Now let's go to our next destination. This is 13th Street Winery. They are in St. Catharines, and they are about, over here I'm kind of showing you from Toronto, about an hour and 17 minutes. The only thing about these guys is that they are closed on Sunday. This was Canada Day, so lots of people just celebrating outside. But what I loved about this place is, first of all, it's just beautiful visually. You can walk around. They have the winery, they have the bakery. I really like the bakery, because they had these wild cherry tarts, and actually they had lots of different things. I think we got about six things, and they were all so yummy. I would dare say that these were the best butter tarts I've had in Ontario in a while. In addition to yummy butter tarts, they have an art gallery. So they have the outdoor art gallery, completely free. You go in, just explore. On a field, really intricately cut out with a lawnmower so that you kind of guide it through the art. Over here is a hay ball, and then you realize that it's an imitation of a hay ball. I'm not sure what this is, but this is very cool. If anybody knows what that is, please message, please write it down below. This is probably one of my favorite art sculptures. It's a Canadian leaf and it kind of floats in the wind and it turns. I don't know how many exactly sculptures there are, but again, took us about a good hour to just walk through, take pictures, enjoy the art. Really beautiful. But also they have indoor art, so it actually started raining just as soon as we got in, which was very lucky. And at this point, this was about July of 2022, they had the graduates, alumni of OCAD University, and just maybe I think three of them. And yeah, you get to see gorgeous artworks. Of course, you can buy them if you would like to. But just the atmosphere was so amazing, very lovely people too. So the next destination is actually not that far. It is St. Catharines Museum and Welland Canals Center. So the inside, you can definitely learn more about the Welland Canal. But what I loved about this experience is that you have this bridge and totally free to enter, totally free to just explore. And you can go up this bridge and then you get to watch all of these boats arrive and use this lock. So over here we went into museum because we said we were told there was a volunteer on the bridge that told us that it's about 15 minute wait. So we had some 15 minutes to spare to just kind of learn about the museum. But by the way, the volunteer mentioned that the schedule of the boats is posted on their Facebook. So St. Catharines Museum Facebook every day. And over here we're seeing gorgeous big ship. It felt almost like the ship is not gonna make it through because it's so wide and the channel is not that wide. So it was interesting seeing that. And over here is the ship. It's gotten pretty much at the location and they were kind of fastening it to make sure that I think they were supposed to get the water down so that the ship can lower and it can go down the lock. But we waited for about 20 minutes and nothing was happening. So we asked the volunteer and he mentioned that it could be another 20 minutes, but we had to run. And this concludes my underrated road trips part two. And I am going to do next the underrated road trips part three. So make sure to follow me and check out the part three, which I'm gonna link down below. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.